Our study was tasked with doing clinical trials for interventions for menopause. We were a group of investigators, multi-site, across the country from Oakland in California, Indianapolis in the Midwest, Pennsylvania, Harvard, and Seattle. We looked most specifically at non-hormonal treatments because the NIH was looking for alternatives. Classic symptoms we hear about are the hot flashes and the night sweats. I have to say, more commonly today, I see patients that are tolerating those to a degree. What women are more worried about is their ability to sleep and therefore function in their home and their workplace. So I think the good thing that came from our study is that there are options for women, that for women that are unable to take hormones. We looked specifically at selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, or SSRIs. These are medications most commonly used for mood or depression. When used at lower doses, prior work had suggested that these were relatively effective for hot flashes and menopausal symptoms. And what we found was that neither the exercise or the yoga improved the frequency or the severity of hot flashes over regular exercise or routine activity, and the omega-3 fatty acid versus an omega-3 placebo was not effective. What we did see, and we've already known this, is that both exercise and yoga are very good for everyone's health and very important for quality of life, and particularly for exercise, physical health. Yoga, we saw improvement in overall sense of well-being or quality of life. Our last trial looked at sleep, and this was an intervention where we did a telephone-based cognitive behavioral therapy for sleep in women with menopausal symptoms, and specifically sleep symptoms related to menopause. This had not been studied before, and the party line had been, again, that estrogen was effective for sleep at midlife, and a telephone-based intervention was as good, if not better, than the estrogen. This kind of intervention, it would be exciting to see healthcare organizations looking at rolling out. These is a simple telephone-based therapy that would be cost-effective and not have to involve medication for women. It's really critical to have women prioritize what's bothering them the most. I ask them to literally list in order the things that they want to improve upon, and then we choose selective therapies for those rather than a broader medication to really target the areas that they're most interested in improving. The other thing I say to all my patients is we can feel fairly confident that almost all women, we have something that we can do to help them with. Even if they've got a wicked hot flashes from a breast cancer, there are some tools that we have that are really going to help each individual woman.